I'm not your monkey. Hi, I'm Burke Holland.
And I'm Don Abramov.
And this is five things about Create React App. Number one, Create React App is a tool for scaffolding React applications. What exactly does it do?
Let's say you get started with React by just a single command. So you install Create React App, you run it, and then you have a project that is a React app.
Because creating React apps can be kind of a pain with Webpack and all of the different build tools. So Create React App kind of makes that super easy.
Yeah, so there is no configuration involved. You don't need to like read anything. It's just you just run it and it works.
And how much does it cost?
It's free.
Just today or all the time?
All the time.
Where can I get it?
That's a good question. You can get it on NPM. You can install it.
You can get anything on NPM.
You can just Google it.
Google it.
Just Google it.
You can get Create React App on NPM. You can get waffles on NPM.
Yeah.
NPM install waffles. Seriously, that actually works. Created by...
me. I'm sorry.
Number two, Create React App is not a boilerplate. What is the difference between a boilerplate and a scaffolding tool, exactly?
The approach taken by Create React App is different. It gives you a project that has just one development dependency, and there's migration instructions for each version, so like you can update it, and under the hood, we keep all the configs inside of it, and we maintain the configs, so you don't have to do that.
One of my favorite things about Create React App is that you don't actually have to have Create React App installed to build an app that was created with Create React App.
Yeah.
Because of the single dependency, I guess it's just one on React Scripts,
yeah.
You just have to have React Scripts, which can then do the build, which
yeah.
is pretty awesome.
Yeah.
Has it always been that popular? That's a stupid question. Sorry. You should have just said that's a stupid question. Here we go. Number three, Create React App is a very opinionated project setup, but what if you have your own opinions?
You have two options. You have three options. My favorite option is you just kind of like forget your opinions. So I think that we do a good job of choosing the language features that are stable enough that we, like even if they change, if there are still proposals and they change, we actually use those at Facebook. So we're going to release a code mod or something like this to update the applications. If for some reason that doesn't work for you, you have two options. One option is called eject. So if you run eject, it's going to copy all the configs and all the build dependencies directly into your project. So at that point, it's just like any scaffolding tool. You're left with this kind of skeleton that you created, and now you maintain it. Like, we can help you.
So I'm basically forking your opinionated setup at that point.
At that point in time, yeah. And there is also another way which I think companies are starting to use more, which is that you maintain a fork of that development dependency. Your projects are not going to have configuration. But since you need custom configuration, like for your company, for example, company-wide, you just have your own fork of React scripts of the development dependencies. And you try to take upstream changes into it, but you also have some modifications that are specific to your workflows. So this way, like people who create projects in your company, they don't have to deal with configuration, and you just manage it for them.
So eject, if you're brave enough, but then you're on your own.
Yeah.
A click away.
Number four, Create React App has its own development server that it runs on. So how would I use that like in the same project with a backend server?
There is a feature called proxy that's very easy to use. You just put a thing in your package.json file that says what's the URL of your backend, and then Create React App will automatically proxy any requests that, so you can just fetch as if you were running on the same server, but then it's gonna see that, oh, actually, this is not a JavaScript file that we're serving. So it's gonna redirect that request to your backend. And in production, you would just serve both from the same, you would not use a development server in production.
Right, so in production, you could just build and then point to
yeah, that's just a static bundle. So you just serve JavaScript and CSS as usual.
It's probably going to be faster than me.
Number five, Create React App apps are PWAs by default. So what does Create React App provide that makes it a PWA?
So by default, we generate an app manifest and a service worker. And the service worker, the implementation that we ship, will cache the JavaScript and CSS files. So if you refresh the page, it's going to serve from the cache. And the app is offline capable by default. But you can remove that if you don't need this.
So your app can be a progressive web app, or it can't. It's up to you.
Yep.
And now, a question from Twitter. All right, this question is, can you easily deploy a project built by Create React App to GitHub Pages or to anywhere?
If you go to Create React App repo, there's going to be a link called User Guide. So if you click that, there will be a bunch of topics, like how do you do this or that or the other thing. And there's a whole section on deployment, and it has a subsection about GitHub Pages. So just go and check it out. It's like five easy steps.
That's true. And actually, there's subsections for all of the big hosters, I believe, on Create React App.
Yeah, and so if there is not, you can submit a pull request, and I'll probably approve it.
That's it. So if you see one that you want up there that's not up there, send one in. In the meantime, I know there's instructions for Azure, for Heroku, for GitHub, and many others. I'm Burke Holland.
And I'm Tan Abramov.
And now you know five things about Create React App.
That's not bad.